Hey guys, it's Chris with Retro Crypt back for another video and stream. I'm going to be playing some more of the Guise. 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 Not two or more men. Okay. Now that we got that out of the way, I played a little bit more earlier, and I found some, not obviously not secrets, but just figured out where I was supposed to go. I figured out how to. I realized I never equipped any of my familiars, so that's what the little flying dude is. So, if we go into the menu, it's familiar, so at Death Head, Plague Bat, Zombie Flies, try this dude, just to give you a, there's like a little, so in the part of the map we're in right now is the Valley of Demons, so to complete one of the side quests, it called for killing three angels. So that's what I did. Assuming, yeah, that's definitely a cliff that I just fell off of, because you never know with this game. So I just wanted to try that real quick. Yeah, shit. Got too close. Whoa. Gun. Yeah, this game, it's, you know, it's not super difficult, but you just have to be on top of things. I feel like it's definitely fair, so yeah, I couldn't, this is one of the areas where one of the three angels is located, or was located before I killed it. So this was blocked by, I don't really know what to call it, like a rock formation of some sort. So if you hold down A, you can do that, and it blows up that rock formation. So those three, on the map, the three tiles on the sort of middle right, towards the right, that just appeared, so I'm assuming that's one of the next places I'm gonna have to go. Not too sure how I'm gonna get there, so I'm just gonna have to explore a little bit. So that's when your magic spells execute. So if you take off, if you deal a little bit of damage to certain enemies and then you walk around them, you can press X after you learn that magic spell. And you execute them. Very cool. It's very stylized, this game. Trial and error, it's like any game. I definitely really don't I don't want to use a walkthrough too much, or at all, really. No, so, yeah, that's how you execute goblin demon things, demons. Right, so, I don't really think I need, hold on, these, yeah, so there's one more magic spell to learn on the bottom right there. So whenever you learn one, there's like two to three levels of each spell, so you need to purchase the second and third level, so you can, so the eyes, collecting the eyes is the way that you do that. So right now I'm still gonna need to collect them. Heal myself. And that's cool, because if you execute one enemy and there's a couple other in the vicinity, that action will deal damage to the other ones, the untargeted ones as well, which is pretty helpful, because you could just kind of like one shot a group of different enemies all at once. I wish I would have played this from the beginning and made YouTube videos for it, because this game has been very enjoyable. It's really intuitive, it's not super difficult. Not that a game needs to be easy or anything, I just, especially with more like retro revival type games, I feel like the developers make them like annoyingly difficult at times. Not that old games weren't that. I just feel like, you know, make it enjoyable. Don't make it, you know, quote unquote Nintendo hard. Because a lot of those older games are great for nostalgia's sake, but some of them are just annoying at points. Alright, so unexplored location. There's two left. Really wouldn't like to know how to get up there. I feel like the majority of the game has been very intuitive to this point, and now we're kind of getting towards the end and it's becoming a bit more cryptic. Again, I love the art style of this game. It's just really creative. It pulls from a lot of different games. Like, I'm seeing Guacamelee, I'm seeing Inside Nimbo. Obviously, there's the Metroid influence. So stuff like that. looks like almost like those old Hanna-Barbera cartoons. And it kind of like mashes up really well against the backdrop, you know, in the foreground here. An enemy down here, a boss character. And I've already been down here. Yeah, where do I? I really don't know where to go. I'm kind of at a loss. I know I could pull up a strategy guide and a walkthrough. I'm really trying to figure it out on my own at this point. I don't want to jinx it, but I think I know where to go. Got my wheels turning now. The other game that I was trying to think of that this reminds me of. And that reminds me, I still have to finish Shovel Knight. I got up to the very last boss and just, I don't know. That happens in a lot of games where I get up to the very, very end and I just, for whatever reason, I just start playing something else. Alright, so I found the ring from the grave digger earlier. Now I have to find. So, quests, where's quests? Maynard the Mighty completed. Boat ticket, find a boat ticket. Family heirloom, give Rudy the ring. So I have to give Rudy the ring. I don't know where return to Tyrell. I don't believe that I did that earlier. Not saying that I did. I don't know, maybe I didn't save. I'm gonna have to circle back. May not be quite as good at these games as others, but still enjoy them. And I feel like they're releasing a lot of Metroidvanias at this point. So there's tons of material to work with. Section, so although I couldn't reach these guys. I didn't have this familiar equipped, so maybe now that'll do. That'll make a difference. Not gonna lie, this is it's not frustrating because I feel like I'm getting there, like I'm gonna have that aha moment. Came over here earlier and then died and never came back. I don't want to celebrate too early because I don't want to get excited and then it's just another dead end. But cautiously. Cautiously optimistic right at the moment. Oh. No. Yo. Really blend in. So right now I'm trying to gain those green orbs so I could fill my energy level back up. So when you get 10 of them, you can get one life, one health point back. So your HP is up at the top left, those circles. Oop. Yeah, that's not it. Almost caught a bandsaw up the ass. Oh, yeah. Yes, this is where I came before, and this is before I had the, what is it called, so I could actually call it what it is. Regurgitation, yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. Progress is being made. So every 5 seconds that guy could fire off a whatever energy projectile. Gotta be very careful here. Happened in the Valley of Demons, that place off to the far right. Like earlier, I was like, let me just go back and make sure that I didn't miss anything over there, and that's where the three angels were to complete that one side quest, which led to me getting the concrete stone cranium. Just gonna stay up here and let him take care of that. To go. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Just have to be very, very careful. Oh, I remember. Maybe I was up here and I just died and never came back, because I remember this now. Yeah, I was definitely up here, because I remember this now. I don't know how I forgot. Look at that blade. That's surreptitiously placed. Oh. Saved up there. Yeah. Just gotta be careful, that's all. Let me see if equipping slowly sucks life from nearby enemies. Okay. Maybe. Better to have this equipped. That's cool, but I thought it was going to give me my energy back. Try you. Oh, what in the shit? get hit. Because I kind of know the area now. The topography, if you will. Guy's the best. We did say we were going to avoid. Be terrible. Gah. I'm gonna get through there. Just run through. Stay away. Don't worry about any of these guys. Thank you. just keep timing these things so poorly. Like that. Oh, you motherfucker. Dude. Keep jinxing myself, too. Double whammy. Mm. here too, every single time. I did hit down, and you still fucking walked right through it. Progress. There's a big puzzle element here. More so than the rest of the game. Notice he kind of like, after you stop hitting over, like he takes a couple extra, like one extra step, and it makes it hard to like really properly gauge. My movements at times. Sometimes because I'm holding down A to do the regurgitation technique, and you could hear it, but he's not actually doing it. Okay, did it now. Totally missed. It's not that difficult, it's like you just have to be precise. It's not difficult or unfair, you just have to know where you're at. Oh, it's no time to glitch out. See, he does this, where he just kind of like freezes in downward dog. And jump doesn't work. Over here, because like if you fall off a platform or something, he stops doing that. Yes, yes, yes. We made it. We made it to another save point. More death beams. Hooray. The mayor, damn, your house is kind of out of the way, man. He's got a gold tooth. Love this music, too. Oof. Just made it. This game will make you question every freaking thing. since they made it here, but a lot more. Forces you to be very precise. Better to take these guys out while you have the ability to, just so you could save up some HP. This time. I swear, I feel like I'm second. guessing everything I'm doing at this point. Because you just have to be uber precise with this game. Better. I already lost 4 hit points. I'm getting closer. couldn't make it with full power. Boat ticket, yes. That's what I've been looking for forever. Bag of coins. Fuck yeah. And this is the door that I couldn't get through before. Let me make sure I save because I will fucking lose it. Thank you. feel like it's taken forever to get to this one teleport spot. Of purification imminent. It's new, so this is very much like Pentacore, where the game Pentacore that I was playing through, where I'm really surprised that this game isn't getting as much credit. It's getting more than Pentacore did, but you know, not really by much. So it's like a hidden gem. Alright. Here we go. Couldn't do this for the longest. It's very Simon's Quest. You need to take it to ride the boat. Sunken Village. This is where I have to get to the shaman to release the curse, I mean. Very cool. Guise. Excellent, excellent, excellent. There's so many watery areas that you can't go in this game. And I feel like that definitely adds an element. Like, now I could go back to, look at this. It's gonna hurt me. Man, it's such a good game. Such a good game. Viet Cong's. It's like peekaboo. But that is so fucking cool. Just the imagination it took to come up with all these enemies. It's just drawn so well. I gotta find a safe spot and then call it a night because I want to eat my dinner and go to sleep. Here, save, and we shall return tomorrow, where I will be playing more of the Guise, and I also would love to finish Super Metroid. So thank you guys for stopping in. Enjoy the rest of your night. Later.